Before we get started in my favorite program on the entire planet, Adobe Photoshop, let's stop and talk about another program that comes bundled with Photoshop that I think is totally underused, Adobe Bridge. Its primary purpose in life is to organize stuff, but not just Photoshop. That's the cool thing. You can organize your Illustrator documents, your InDesign documents. You can organize your Microsoft Word documents. As a matter of fact, Bridge is a good tool, if you want to use it for this, to organize your entire hard drive. To get to it, we're going to go up to the word File on the pull-down menu and go down to Browse in Bridge. You may have noticed something if you are a longtime user of Photoshop. We used to have something in Photoshop called the Mini Bridge, but because it was not really used that much, it's not there anymore. So let's go into the full-blown version right here. Now, before we get into the things that are going on, like the favorites and the content, if you know anything about me, I like talking preferences. Preferences do two things. They allow you to get more efficient, and that's a good thing. And they also allow the system to be put together the way you want it to be. That's aesthetics. And I want to tell you something. If you're controlling things, you're happy. You're going to be more creative. So let's do this. If you're on a Windows system, go to the word Edit. If you're on a Mac, and I am, go Adobe Bridge and go into Preferences. You can also use the shortcut, and that's Command on a Mac, Control in Windows, letter K. Now, we start with General. You start with Appearance. If you don't like what you see over here, click a button. Make it different. If you don't like the presets, you come over here and you click and you can drag the slider. This is totally up to you. Now, let me move that over just a little bit, because we also have another one for image backdrop. And if I click that, we can change the backdrop area. I'm going to take that back to default. We have another area called the accent color. Look up at the word essential. See the color? Come over here. You see the color over here too. If I change to, say, system, those areas begin to change. If you don't like the default, you could try one of these if you want to. I'm going to take it back to default. We have behavior options. For example, if a camera is connected, do you want it to automatically launch the Adobe downloader? I usually don't. Double-click edits camera raw settings. Command-click opens the loop when previewing or reviewing. Those might make more sense when we get into this a little bit more. How many items do you want to recently display? And my favorite items, which happen to be over here, these, I can add those or subtract. Now, we can also add our own favorites, which we'll do. If we get into some of these others, for example, thumbnails, performance and file handling, don't process images larger than 1,000 megabytes. What that does, basically, it makes the system more efficient and keeps it from processing these huge images. You can also change what you see for an image. You can say date created, dimensions, keywords, and actually anything that you want. And you can show tooltips. You have playback options for audio and video. You have what you want displayed from metadata. We will talk about keywords, and we will talk about labels. This one right here is very important. When you double-click on something inside the bridge, what program opens it? Now, you can come over here, and you can change them. You got another program you want to use? You can use it. Cache, another important one. Keep 100% previews means you have a preview that's the same size as the original image. Do you want to automatically export the cache to folders when possible? Here's the location of the cache. Now, the default is inside the folder that comes along with Photoshop and the bridge. There's probably very little reason why you would want to change that. This right here allows you to load, as bridge is open, X number of images, the thumbnails from the cache. You can go up to 500,000. Now, if you go there, your system is going to be much more efficient, but you're going to need a lot of disk space to make that happen. Look at these two here, compact and purge. When you use compact, you are fixing and compacting the cache to make it more efficient. You might want to do that, like, say, once a month if you use bridge a lot. Purging means I got a problem. For example, the bridge is just not working as fast as it used to, and it is occasionally blowing up on you and crashing. You could have corrupted files in the cache. If you purge the cache, you're not touching your images. You're forcing the cache to rebuild from scratch. That's all that does. And if you got problems, click the button. Startup scripts right here just help Bridge work with other programs. you do have some advanced features like using software rendering as opposed to hardware, generate monitor size previews, start bridge at login. Nah, I'll start it when I want it. And what language? Language to me is English, and the keyboard is English. You make changes, you click OK if you want to save them, you click cancel if you wish you hadn't done that. If you know anything about me, preferences are a very important part of working with any program. Set them up before you get started.